welcome to the 16th Annual Human Growth Foundation Awards Virtual Gala. This evening is going to be incredible with attendees tuning in from all over the world. You know, there's nothing like a virus to bring us all together. But seriously, this evening is going to be one of inspiration, celebration, and motivation as we are joined by some phenomenal men, women, and children from all across the country and overseas. Throughout the evening, you can bid on some amazing auction items at hgfgala.net, hgfgala.net. You can also take a break and mingle with other gala attendees in the reception hall, or as I like to call it, the mingle room. Gold sponsor Pfizer. As well as visit all of the virtual sponsored display rooms. Without further ado, allow me to introduce the Chief Medical Officer of the Rare Disease Group at Pfizer, Kevin Williams.
Good evening, and welcome to all of you, albeit virtually. My name is Kevin Williams, and I'm the Chief Medical Officer in our Rare Disease Group here at Pfizer. It's clear that this year is different. We've had to change a lot about our daily lives, how we interact with family and friends, and for many of us, even the way in which we spend an average workday has evolved. But one thing remains the same, the commitment we've all made to people living with growth disorders. For many families, school and even checkups with the doctor are now virtual. So it remains more important than ever to watch for signs of growth delay. Height plays a critical role in children's health monitoring. So tracking growth could help the 1 in approximately 4,000 to 10,000 children worldwide living with growth disorders to reach their full growth potential. And while I suspect all of us here tonight have an understanding of growth disorders, many people do not. After all, this is a rare disease. So building understanding and awareness of growth disorders is more important than ever. In fact, early diagnosis often leads to early treatment, which may increase the child's chance to achieve catch-up growth and help them to be their healthiest self. At Pfizer, we are passionate about our work in rare diseases and continue our research of new treatments for people living with growth disorders. We collaborate with professional societies and patient advocacy organizations to increase awareness and education on growth disorders, and also fund research to advance the science in this space. Our job is not done, though. We have the opportunity to do our part to help the Human Growth Foundation achieve its mission of expanding and accelerating research into rare genetic growth and bone disorders and providing education, patient support, and patient advocacy to both children and adults. Although we cannot be with each other in person tonight, I invite you to join me in making this commitment. Together, we can make a difference. Thank you.
Thanks, Kevin. Building the awareness and understanding of growth and bone disorders is the Human Growth Foundation's fundamental mission. Let's take a look.
I was always smaller than all the other kids all throughout elementary school, but it wasn't till fourth grade where I really noticed that there'd be all these tall kids and then me. And in those pictures, I looked like I was years younger than all the kids.
We're both, you know, very concerned about that. We watched him very closely. We were very protective of him.
We knew that we had to do something.
Every parent wants their child to measure up, whether in school, in sports, or in level of maturity. A parent's desire is for their child to at least be equal to the level of their peers. But what if your child doesn't measure up in stature?
You worry about your child. You want to find out, is there something you can do?
In children, there is often a feeling of anxiety about their small stature and slow growth. Often, they are teased, bullied, and it may be damaging for their sense of self-esteem.
Some of the kids tried to get up in my face and make fun of it more and be like, you have a condition and there's nothing you can do about it.
It made me feel a little embarrassed and sad.
The frustration is often compounded when parents are not sure what causes their child's growth failure or what to do about it.
then depend on the etiology. Some of those particular patients could be treated, so the diagnosis is very important. What is the cause of growth disorder, and some specific treatment could be implemented.
This is why the Human Growth Foundation was established in 1965, so no family travels this path alone. It is the oldest and largest nonprofit of its kind, with parents and friends of children and adults with growth problems, physicians, and other healthcare professionals.
The Human Growth Foundation has been an excellent source of support and assistance for us.
I'm about to cry.
The Human Growth Foundation mission encompasses areas of education, outreach, and advocacy. One of our goals, of course, is to reach and provide relevancy to the different populations of people affected by growth disorders.
We have an educational committee who writes booklets about the different disorders that are related to growth. They're written in a way that parents can fully understand the medical aspect of what their child is going through. We also have an internet support list on our website, one for the parents of children and one for adults.
I had an excellent endocrinologist. She was the one who recommended HGF. Those are the things that matter to me.
Recognized as a global leader in endocrine care and advocacy, the Human Growth Foundation offers a wide range of workshops for parents.
It's a great educational experience, and it helps all levels of all parents to understand what's going on.
The organization works to keep physicians and other healthcare providers abreast of the latest developments with dedicated workshops across the country and even overseas.
Without Human Growth Foundation helping us to get together once a year, we're not able to collaborate and share ideas and thoughts and approaches.
It's a great opportunity to interact with people that are at the cutting edge of bone disorders and to discuss with them some of the findings and some of my patients that have been challenging.
Take your mark, set!
The Human Growth Foundation brings the community together with family fun events and calls on the aid of Hollywood celebrities to increase awareness of growth disorders and the importance of early diagnosis and treatment.
Helping people is a passion of mine, and it's just really an honor for me to be able to give back.
And while the Human Growth Foundation is making a difference in the lives of those impacted by growth disorders and growth hormone deficiency, it needs you, the community, to be a part of this growing solution.
If you can donate, please do so. We need your help.
Helping people is good.
This is the one gift that keeps on growing.
Hi, my name is Travis Burnett. I'm a 14-year-old actor, and I play Claude on the Disney Plus series Diary of a Future President, and the boy on AMC's Dispatches from Elsewhere, opposite Jason Segel. I am honored to be a part of the Human Growth Foundation's 16th Annual Awards Gala. As a young person who wants to reach the stars, I am honored to introduce this evening's next speaker. He is osteogenesis imperfecta, and despite the challenges that come with this rare bone disorder, he is reaching new heights in his own way. Please welcome 8-year-old Caden Casebolt.
My name is Caden. I am 8 years old. I have osteogenesis imperfecta, and there are many different types of OI. And I have a type 3, and I have over 50 broken bones because of my condition. And my parents told me that some doctors told them that I would not have a normal life. And then they took me to see Dr. Steelman, and they gave me what I call bone juice. It helps me support my bones so I don't break them so much. It helps me walk. So much. It helps me so much. And because of Dr. Stillman's help, I am able to live like a normal kid. One day I hope I can play sports like culture basketball. This could not be possible without the people at the Human Growth Foundation.
Sure, it can be a scary place, living outside what's safe. But if you have the passion for a dream, well, that dreamer must be chased. And I won't let the fear of what's unknown tackle me from what comes next. I may never see the golden road, but you know I'll try my best. Cause sometimes dreams are made for something more than just to dream. I have waited all my life for this, and it has just begun. The fighting that it took to get me here proves to me that I've already won. And if one day I see I've lost my place, trust me, there'll be pride within me still. Cause even if the mountain's out of reach, I'll be conquering a thousand hills. Cause it is not how far uphill you get, but how passionate the climb. And even if it takes a thousand years, trust me, I will do the time. Cause there has never been a love that drives me quite like. Just begun. The fighting that it took to get me here proves to me that I've already won. It's up to us to make our own place in this world. Don't ever let your life pass you by. And I have and it has just begun. The fighting that it took to get me here proves to me that I've already won. Oh, and I've already won.
Turn more music by American Idol's Casey McQuellen, special appearance by comedian Brad Williams, HGF past president Dr. Duke, and more. Stay with us.
The mission of Ascendis is to make transformative medicines for the patients.
Patients, passions, and science.
The patients are at the front and at the back of everything we do here.
There's an energy across the entire company.
Every one of us wants to make an impact.
Everybody is working towards the same goal.
To optimize patient care.
Address the unmet medical need for patients.
Give them a better quality of life.
Enable a normal life again.
Make people's life better.
Create real benefits for patients.
Have an impact on every patient.
All of our decisions are driven by the interest of patients.
We are there for the patients.
That is the mission we all have, to help patients.
We're here
for patients.
For the patients.
For the patients. And we want to deliver the best.
Thank you.
Now that was a nice break. I had a chance to meet with some of the attendees tonight. We shared a few laughs, toasted through the net in the mingle room. She hails from Canada, and America has had the opportunity to fall in love with her on the multi-award winning show, Schitt's Creek. Please welcome Sarah Levy.
Welcome, everyone. Thank you for joining us for the 16th annual Human Growth Foundation Virtual Awards Gala. I'm Sarah Levy, and while I'm known best for my role as Twyla on the Emmy-winning show Schitt's Creek, I'm also a huge believer that all children should be given the opportunity to grow. That's why it gives me great pleasure to introduce Dr. Pisit Pachukiwanat, known best as Dr. Duke. For more than a decade, Dr. Duke has worked tirelessly for children and adults with growth and bone disorders and pushed the organization forward as a leader in the nonprofit world of endocrine advocacy.
Hello, my name is Dr. Duke. I am the president of Human Growth Foundation.
It's his personality and just his vitality that really make him such a great leader. And I remember thinking to myself that he would be a perfect person on the board for Human Growth Foundation. And Duke had one idea after another to try to raise money for HGF and keep all our great programs and expand them.
You guys ready?
Human Growth Foundation is a nonprofit organization.
Our mission is to increase awareness of growth disorder.
Welcome to this Annual Bullying Festival. This event is all about empowerment.
If they have some issue with bullying, make sure you listen to your children.
Look out, cause here I come. And I'm marching on to the beat I drum. I'm not scared to be seen. I make no apologies. This is me.
Human Growth Foundation have been setting up education program around the U.S.
Not limited to pediatric endocrinologists, but all the pediatricians.
And we know that it's very important to reaching out across the globe as well.
Pediatric Bone Symposium is very important because diagnosis and management is a major issue to treat. We have very few experts in this field.
When I think about all the things he's done, it's just too numerous to count. Like the gala was his idea.
Reaching a new height is not just a catchy slogan. It is our foundation mission to increasing awareness of growth disorder.
I take a shot every day called Human Growth Hormone. I am told by Dr. Duke that this will make me taller.
He's a giver. We're very grateful for his work.
When I saw him coming down the hallway, I knew I loved him. We struggled with several different doctors. He's been a saving grace for my family.
He's a brilliant man.
They told me I would know who you are when I saw you because they said you were so fly. Yeah, they were not lying. Yeah.
Let us please welcome to the stage the Foundation's fearless leader, whose vision inspires many, and who is always stylishly dressed. Please welcome none other than
Dr. Duke Pachukiwanat.
Dr. Duke.
Dr. Duke.
Dr. Duke.
Dr. Duke.
Please join me in welcoming Dr. Duke.
Hello, and welcome to the 16th Annual Human Growth Foundation Award Gala. What an incredible feeling of appreciation I have this evening. knowing that so many of you have joined us from around the world for this virtual event. The coronavirus pandemic has changed our life and routine worldwide. And these changes may be a new normal for most of us moving forward. However, I would like to wish you a socially distanced, unprecedented, happy, and healthy holidays. It is hard to believe that 13 years ago, I came to the Human Growth Foundation as a board member and became the president shortly after that. I look a lot younger then. I believe that the Human Growth Foundation could create a stronger community for those affected by growth disorder, their families, healthcare providers, and those who were willing to help us provide better research, outstanding education, more vital support, and increased advocacy. It was a belief some may call a shot in the dark. This evening, I stand before you to say thank you. Thank you for your support. Thank you for your unwavering belief that Human Growth Foundation could deliver on that promise. Your health and continuous trust have given us confidence, stamina, and strength in the face of challenges to reach new heights. Over the past 10 years, we have worked harder and more diligently than ever before. We create programs that offer healthcare providers an opportunity to learn from industry thought leaders in what we call Human Growth Foundation Endocrine Educational Days. We provide grants that have afforded those new in the fields an opportunity to showcase their research. These grants are distributed annually at the Pediatric Academic Society and the Pediatric Endocrine Nurses Society meetings. We have provided more significant advocacy work for families impacted by growth disorder throughout our National Family Day program and with our national 5K run and walk for kid growth. One of our most extensive national programs, Say No Bullying, which gives a voice to those who were once unempowered. We have even expanded our mission to help children with growth disorder and adult with growth hormone deficiency and individual with rare bone disorder. Our mission to increase awareness of growth and bone disorder has led many to be diagnosed and receive necessary therapy. We have collectively helped hundreds of thousands of people reach new heights, pun intended, through research, education, patient support, advocacy. Our foundation is larger, stronger, and more prosperous by so many measures than when we started this journey together. All these outstanding accomplishments cannot be the work of one, it's all of us. I have so many people to thank, all the committee chairs, the board of directors, and our administrative staff. What we have learned over the past 10 years is that our work is never entirely done. Each day it begins again. We continuously work to find a comprehensive solution that builds a shorter bridge connecting our family and healthcare providers. And it is possible to do that by fostering the next generation of thought leaders, including 5 new Human Growth Foundation board members, and knowing that we have supporters like you. In fact, it's knowing that no matter how far we want to reach, you are behind us. With your presence, your donation, and your corporate giving, and for that, we thank you. We have more work to do, and we continue to make progress while reaching new heights for everyone impacted by growth, bone disorder, and growth hormone deficiency. As I step down as president of this great organization, I must say, it has been a very affirming experience. When I decided to retire from this position, I also decided to nominate someone who shared this same passion for this foundation. I know my successor, Dr. Joe Stillman, will continue to share the foundation and our community with the greatest of his ability. As a former Airman U.S. Air Force, he knows firsthand that the sky is not a limit, and he will surely help Human Good Foundation to reach even greater heights. These last 13 years have changed my life, and I'm forever grateful to you and the Human Good Foundation for giving me this incredible opportunity. Thank you.
Needless to say, we will all miss Dr. Duke. Please join me in welcoming our next presenter, fellow comedian, Brad Williams. Brad?
Hi, my name is Brad Williams. I'm an actor and a comedian, and also a little person, so that makes me qualified to talk to you about the Human Growth Foundation. It's an honor to join you all this evening for this virtual gala. The Human Growth Foundation makes a difference in the lives of children and adults with growth and bone disorders by providing not only resources, but advocacy as well. With your support this evening, they can continue fulfilling their mission. Please consider making a donation online at hgfound.org. And now, without further ado, please welcome the president of the Human Growth Foundation, Dr. Joel Stillman.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the 16th Annual Human Growth Foundation's Gala Award. This year is a new venue, a virtual platform, which will allow people from around the world to participate. We thank our gold sponsor, Pfizer, and our silver sponsors, Arbor Pharmaceuticals, Endo Pharmaceuticals, Ascendis Pharma, and Novo Nordisk, for your support in standing with us as we step into a new platform this evening. We will showcase the excellent work they provide in the community later in this program. We, the Human Growth Foundation, want to thank you all as well, those of you participating in this virtual event. We appreciate your support, and we're grateful that you all are taking time from your schedules to watch this program and participate. What can I say? 2020 has been a challenging and difficult year for many of us. This year has seen the specter of illness, separation from family and loved ones, difficulties with rising unemployment, and an economy that still has not shown signs of recovery. There's a new reality of a confined and virtual world that many of us live in. But there's still optimism and hope, I believe. I believe that through our eyes we can communicate small glimmers of hope and optimism as we don our ever-present masks and go out into the community to do our work and meet with families. The Human Growth Foundation also has faced these challenges as well as we live in confined and virtual life. The needs of children, families, and healthcare providers for the support and advocacy that the Human Growth Foundation provides remains, though. And it's our mission, and we're committed to overcoming the present obstacles and reach new heights. We're committed to provide support in research, education, and advocacy and patient support for children and adults impacted by growth disorders, bone disorders, and growth hormone deficiency. The Human Growth Foundation appreciates your support as members, as those who've donated, and as volunteers. Your efforts make all of this possible for us. Many of you have already contributed by simply being part of this gala this evening. I thank you all for your support. For those of you who would like to provide more support or provide additional support, please visit our website at hgfound.org and look for the green donate button in the upper right-hand corner. Also, we have a virtual auction, so please, if you're inclined, stop by hgfound.org/auctions if you're interested in bidding at any of the items in our virtual auction. This evening, we will honor some of our friends and colleagues whose gifts of service span many years and have significantly impacted the field of endocrinology. First, we will honor the remarkable Dr. Jesus Argente, a full professor and chairman of pediatrics and pediatric endocrinology at the University Autonoma de Madrid in Spain. He is the chief of pediatric endocrinology and the director of laboratory research at the University Hospital Niño Jesús in Madrid, Spain. Dr. Argente will receive this year's Visionary Award. Next, we will honor the extraordinary Dr. Walter Miller. Dr. Miller, a distinguished professor of pediatrics emeritus at the University of California at San Francisco, also served as the chief of endocrinology at UCSF Benioff Children's Hospital. He also holds appointments in the Center for Reproductive Science and the Institute of Human Genetics. Dr. Miller will receive the Lifetime Achievement Award. We will also have the chance to hear from three individuals who have growth and bone conditions. They will inspire us, I hope, to see possibilities that come with a positive attitude and a supportive family. We also have some special guests later in our gala and will recognize our rising star, Dr. Kevin Bennett, the 2019 recipient of our small research grant. Before I go, I'm going to take a moment and recognize two remarkable people whose dedication and talent are essential to the Human Growth Foundation. Patty Costa, our executive director, and Daphne Plump, our director of communication development, are instrumental in their daily efforts and dedication to the Human Growth Foundation are going to be reflected in the montage of some of the amazing work that the Human Growth Foundation does throughout the growth and the bone community. Thank you all very much for attending tonight's gala.
Good evening, everyone. I am Patricia Costa, the Executive Director of the Human Growth Foundation, and I am so pleased that so many of you could join us today for our virtual award gala. 2020 started out very well for the Human Growth Foundation. We had completed two of our educational programs already, and we're putting on the final touches of our bone seminar and our gala. When March 13th occurred, everything came to a screeching halt. The Human Growth Foundation is located in New York, which is the center of the COVID-19 virus. On that day, schools closed immediately, businesses closed, and we were all told to remain indoors in our own homes. Quickly, we learned that by staying apart now, we should all be together again later. COVID-19 has touched each and every one of us, but some, the impact has been greater. The people who've had impacts on their business, on their personal lives, and the greatest impact of all on those who have lost a loved one. The Human Growth Foundation felt that we couldn't stop all of our programs, that we had to continue on. However, we had to start to think outside the box to accomplish that. And I must say, I stand here tonight so proud to be able to tell you that at the end of tonight, at the end of our gala, we will have completed each and every program that we had set out to do. I would also like to take this time to thank the Human Growth Foundation's unsung heroes. And that starts with our board of directors, the many doctors, nurses, parents, and lay people who work hard, who come together twice a year, give up of their time to ensure that the Human Growth Foundation is functioning properly, that we're growing to meet the demands of what people need from us. I would also like to thank Amalia Matlis, who works in the office doing the daily task and does an outstanding job. And to Daphne Plump, who puts together all of these events and programs that we have. She was the one who taught us how to Zoom, that we're here where we are today. And I would be remiss if I didn't mention Dr. Duke. As you know, he has retired as president after serving for 9.5 years as president. He and I have worked together all this time, and I can honestly say that his enthusiasm, his ideas, his compassion to help people have helped to make the Human Growth Foundation what it is today, an organization that is known now in many countries all over the world and is recognized here in the United States as something of real importance to both families and the medical professionals. At this time, I would also like to thank our real unsung heroes, heroes that have never been mentioned probably, and that is all the pharmaceutical and the home health care companies who help us, who support us, who are there for us. Yes, we all hear they make a lot of money and stuff, but that's what we all want to do. But in reality, what I have learned to see with them is their compassion to help all of the patients that use their products. They have never said no. They're there for everything for us to make your lives better. So in closing, I just like everybody to remember that when the dust settles, and we now know how little we really need and how much we actually have, that human kindness is priceless. May all of you and your family have a healthy and happy holiday season. Good night.
When we return, a salute to Visionary Award recipient Dr. Jesus Argente and Lifetime Achievement salute to Dr. Walter Miller. Stay with us.
Before we get started, let me just say this. A couple of months ago, I was doing a charity event in La Jolla, California, Southern California, a big, you know, ritzy party thing at a mansion, and preface that by saying everything in my act that I tell you that's a story in my act is probably a true story that actually happened to me. And I embellish it to make it funnier, but most of the stories are true stories. And so this particular night, I'm at this charity event, and I'm about 14 minutes into my hour set. And the host comes up, and he's saying, "I'm sorry, Mark," and he's reaching for the mic. So immediately, I'm running through my head, did I say something that was off color for the charity? And then he says, "Is there a doctor in the house?" There happened to be four doctors in the house that night. One of them was the head ER doctor in San Diego. I killed a guy that night with jokes. If you had to die somewhere that night, that event was the place to be. Because they brought him back, and he woke up giggling. I killed him, my jokes brought him back. So what I'm trying to say to you is here tonight is this. If you know you have a problem with the ticker, I can't be responsible for your health. Just getting that out there. And I was the only black guy in the room. Apparently, again. So my mind started racing. You know, what if the police would have came and said, "What happened to him? Who killed him?" Everybody in the room would have went. And now I gotta have a standoff with the police. Three guys walk into a bar, officer. Then I end up in a cell with Bubba. Bubba's looking at me, so what you in for? I killed the dude, Bubba. With a joke. Knock, knock, Bubba. Are we clear?
At a time when things are most uncertain, we turn to the most certain thing there is, science. Science can overcome diseases, create cures, and yes, beat pandemics. It has before, it will again. Because when it's faced with a new opponent, it doesn't back down. It revs up, asking questions till it finds what it's looking for. That's the power of science. So we're taking our science and unleashing it. Our research, experts, and resources. All in an effort to advance potential therapies and vaccines. Other companies and academic institutions are doing the same. The entire global scientific community is working together to beat this thing. And we're using science to help make it happen. Because when science wins, we all win.
I mentioned earlier in my speech the importance of your support in the mission of the Human Growth Foundation, particularly when it comes to research. We've had the privilege for many years now to provide research support in the form of small research grants. These are given to people in the early phases of their career, either as trainees or early after finishing their training. This is a very important mission of the Human Growth Foundation is important as we support efforts in bone health and in growth conditions. This year I have the privilege of introducing Dr. Kevin Brennan, who is the recipient of our 2019 Small Research Grant Award. Dr. Brennan is a PhD from Stanford, and it's with great pleasure that I introduce him this evening.
My research focuses on understanding the cause of Sotos syndrome, which is a rare genetic disorder that affects approximately one in every 14,000 individuals born. So this condition is associated with accelerated growth during the first years of life. And it's also associated with a number of debilitating conditions, such as delayed intellectual development, seizures, and heart and kidney defects. So the goal of my research is to understand the biology of this disease. So Sotos syndrome is caused in mutations in a gene called NSD1. And so what I want to understand is which genes does this NSD1 gene regulate? And so in order to understand that, I conducted a patient study in which we recruited individuals with Sotos syndrome and their families to participate in our research. And so we're trying to identify genes that are deregulated in Sotos syndrome relative to people without Sotos syndrome. And this is technically a very, this is a technically very simple experiment, but logistically it's very difficult to recruit a large number of individuals with Sotos syndrome and to collect their samples on site. And so this research was really only possible with the help of the Human Growth Foundation and those who donate to it. In the last few months, we have completed a research paper based on the research that we have conducted with this grant. And we're in the process of putting final touches to the research paper and having it published. I'm very confident that we're on the right track with this research towards finding a cure for Sotos syndrome. And so I intend to dedicate my research career to this research. So again, I'd like to thank the Human Growth Foundation, as well as some other organizations. So I want to thank the Sotos Syndrome Support Association, who helped me with recruiting patients for this research. I'd like to thank my research mentors, Drs. Olivia Javert and John Bernstein, as well as my clinical collaborators, Dr. Bradley Schaefer and Dr. Jill Farner. And thank you for listening.
Thanks to Drs. Joel Stillman and Coach Children, I can now participate in activities like volleyball and basketball.
I have been homeschooling since about 6th grade. When I was in kindergarten, I wasn't growing at all, so my parents decided to get me tests for Turner's and found out I had it. Dr. Steelman quickly got me on a treatment plan.
Hi, I'm Casey, and this is our version of Free Woman.
I walk the downtown, hear my sound. No one knows me yet, not right now. And I'm about to say this feeling, emotion. I walk the downtown, hear my sound. I say that I want it. Be free, don't fight it, but if I'm gonna go for it, I remember that I say that I want it, be free, don't fight it, but if I'm gonna go for it, I remember that I'm not nothing without a steady hand, I'm not nothing unless I know I can, I'm still something if I don't got a man, I'm a free woman. This is my dance floor I fought for. A heart, that's what I'm living for. So light up my body and kiss me too hardly. We own the downtown, hear my sound. And I say that I want it, be free, don't fight it. But if I'm gonna go for it, I remember that. I say that I want it, be free, don't fight it. But if I'm gonna go for it, I remember that. I'm not nothing without a steady hand. I'm not nothing unless I know I can. I'm still something if I don't got a man, I'm a free woman. great woman.
Good day. My name is Ron Rosenfeld, and today I have both the honor and privilege of announcing this year's recipient of the Visionary Award from the Human Growth Foundation. The winner this year is my dear friend and colleague, Dr. Jesus Argente, Professor of Pediatrics and Chairman of the Department of Pediatrics in Madrid, and a longtime contributor to pediatric endocrinology. Dr. Argente's accomplishments really span the entire field of pediatric endocrinology, not the least of which is his identification of multiple novel defects throughout the entire growth hormone IGF pathway. He has trained numerous pediatric endocrinologists and is the author of hundreds of papers. He is the three-time recipient of the Henning Anderson Award from ESPE, and in addition, received the prestigious Andrea Prater Award, also from ESPE. He's a past president of both the Spanish Pediatric Endocrine Society and ESPE.
I'm going to say Jesus impacted the world, and truly he is a world-renowned pediatric endocrinologist.
He has a main characteristic, which is he always tries to think forward.
I would describe him really as a citizen of the world. He trained in a number of different countries. He's a clinical scientist of very high quality. For this reason, I would say that he really does have a visionary view of pediatric endocrinology. I got to know Jesus mainly through the European Society of Pediatric Endocrinology, the ESPE. And he hosted an extremely successful annual ESPE meeting in Madrid that year.
ESPE is a place where you can grow scientifically, and also you can grow from a human point of view.
I met Jesus approximately 25 years ago. I was invited by him to an endocrinology conference in Spain. It was a wonderful conference, as I remember, and I really enjoyed meeting him right from the first time.
I met Jesus in my compulsory training in pediatric endocrinology during my pediatric residency. He provided me with the opportunity to develop a career in our country, which was not easy at all.
It's always been a great pleasure working with Jesus. We've worked together on a number of projects and educational initiatives. He's a marvelous teacher.
Working with Jesus has been collaborative. We've shared reagents, we've shared people, have abstracts together, presentations, and we've published together. So it's been a very, very good interaction. Plus, it's been fun.
Working with Jesus was challenging and demanding, for sure. You will always know what he wants, what he thinks, and that's always helpful when having a human and a professional relationship.
Among all those characteristics, he's kind-hearted and a really, really nice person.
Jesus is a caring clinician. He's particularly concerned about the welfare of his patients. And this comes through in his research, but also in his teaching. His teaching is always patient-based.
He's a compassionate doctor in this case. So I think they would have the utmost praise for him and, as important, respect for him.
Jesus is a highly deserving recipient of the Visionary Award. He has carried out research in many areas, neuroendocrinology, obesity, diabetes, and most recently he's embraced the advances of genetics related to growth disorders.
Vision without action is a dream. Conversely, action without vision is a nightmare. Jesus has vision plus action to get something done, and he identified inactivating mutations in a gene called PAPA2. And he's went on to publish several publications about this inactivation of this particular gene. So he's had an impact at many levels. At the patient level, his clinical fellows, and they've gone on to have their careers, his administrative staff, his collaborators worldwide, and then just his spread of his knowledge via presentations and publications. He's a visionary person.
Thank you.
please join me today congratulating Dr. Argente, this year's Visionary Award winner. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much indeed. I would first like to thank the Human Growth Foundation for selecting me to get this Visionary Award 2020. So thank you, because the foundation is doing an excellent job just trying to help children with short stature, not only supporting them, but also doing research in this area. Furthermore, I would like to thank my friends and colleagues, Dr. Ron Rosenfeld and Dr. Martin Savitz, with whom, previous recipients of this award, with whom I had the possibility in the past, and I still have the possibility to discuss many issues about patients with short stature, not only from a clinical point of view, but also from a biochemical, hormonal, and genetic point of view. So I'm currently the chairman of the Department of Pediatrics and Pediatric Endocrinology at the University Hospital Niño Jesús in Madrid, Spain, as well as at the University Autónoma of Madrid. So our university hospital is a national reference, and it's a hospital for sick children. Therefore, we have the possibility to see many children, many complex children, through around the country. So it is time of collaboration. Collaborations in research are fundamental, not only national, but also international, through our colleagues and also through the scientific societies that take care of children with short stature. So it is time of gratitude, and then I would first like to thank our patients and their parents for the interest in studying their children. Otherwise, it would be impossible to do research and to help people. In addition, I would like to thank all of my colleagues from my department. So this Visionary Award is also for them, because we had so many discussions about interesting and complex patients in order to try to get the best diagnosis and also to try to provide our children with the best therapeutical procedures. So it is then time of gratitude, and therefore I would like, before closing, just to mention all of my thoughts and my support to the families with any kind of health problems due to this pandemic, due to the coronavirus outbreak. So I'm positive that we will continue our normal life in the future once we get the vaccine. And also, I would like to let you know that I promise that I will keep this prize, this award, in my heart. And I would like to thank you very much indeed, all of you, with my sincere gratitude and respect to all of you. Thank you very much.
Today, it's my privilege and great honor to announce the winner of this year's Human Growth Foundation Lifetime Achievement Award, which goes to Walter Miller. Walter is somebody I've known for many, many years. He's the Distinguished Professor Emeritus of Pediatrics at University of California, San Francisco, where he has continued the long tradition of academic and clinical excellence pioneered by Mel Grumbach, Selna Kaplan, Felix Conti, and all of their colleagues. Walter, in addition to being the Distinguished Professor, was Chief of the Division of Endocrinology at UCSF for many years. Although his initial work involved the cloning of the genes for bovine growth hormone and prolactin, it's really in the field of adrenal steroidogenesis where Walter has made really remarkable achievements, providing the foundation for understanding the molecular basis as well as the pathophysiology of multiple defects in the adrenal steroid pathway. In addition, he's been involved also in identifying genetic defects in the vasopressin pathway, vitamin D, Ehlers-Danlos, etc. Above all of this, Walter has been a giant in the field of pediatric endocrinology. He's the recipient of multiple awards, not the least of which is the Judson Van Wyk Award from the Pediatric Endocrine Society, as well as the International Award from SB.
Walter Miller is an incredible leader in the field of pediatric endocrinology.
He's a Renaissance man. He reinvented himself maybe three or four times, but I think he was probably proudest about is not his own accomplishments, but the accomplishments of the people that he's trained.
He is scientifically rigorous and wanting to deal with original data, not just what he heard about. That's his legacy.
I've known Dr. Walter Miller for a very long time. The first meeting was at the LWPES meeting in San Antonio in 1980.
I've known Dr. Miller since 1994. I was looking for researchers that might have a possible opening for a scientist in the UCSF Endocrinology Division. I looked him up and discussed research possibilities, and then I joined his lab the following year.
Walt and I have known each other since at least 1966. I don't recall when I first met Walt. My guess is it was at Duke, and we may have done clinical science together.
I thoroughly enjoyed my interactions with Walter. Any paper that I ever did with him showed his meticulous attention to detail and indeed reflected his scientific acumen.
I think he's pretty intense and he's very precise. He doesn't really tolerate people who are sloppy in their thinking or in their writing. He has very high standards and he holds his people to those high standards.
I never worked directly with Walt. Vignette is probably the best way to say it. We had a patient whom we couldn't figure out what the problem was. We knew it was an adrenal problem. At the time, one thought it was side chain cleavage enzyme. It didn't turn out to be that at all. I talked to Walt because I knew he was the best, and as he thought about it, he and another person, Doug Stucco, found a new enzyme called STAR, steroid acute regulatory enzyme. That became part of a very significant paper that showed an enzyme that was deficient. So, to think about it, to get a proper hypothesis, to test it appropriately, that, I think, is the mark of a true scientist.
Dr. Miller is a complex individual. It's a high bar to be considered a friend. He's incredibly devoted to his family and the success of his fellows and colleagues, which I have seen firsthand.
He's also someone that you can have a conversation about almost anything, like stock market, football, politics.
Walt is certainly a proper scientist. He's an iconoclast. He's a stickler for data.
Clearly, he has been chosen to get this Lifetime Award, which is in part a humanitarian award. He has cloned and discovered numerous steroidogenic enzymes and transcription factors. He has described the genetic basis of multiple diseases, including the regulation of adrenal steroid hormones.
Between those discoveries of steroid biosynthesis, the trainees that he has brought into academic medicine, and I'm fortunate to be one of those, I think he leaves a long legacy in his career.
The papers are there, you can read the science, he was the first to do it, and much more importantly, it's being carried forward in his training of postdoctoral fellows all around the world. This is his entire scientific and medical career.
Please join me in congratulating Dr. Miller on this remarkable Lifetime Achievement Award. Thank you.
It's an incredible honor to be selected for the 2020 Lifetime Achievement Award from the Human Growth Foundation. I want to thank the foundation and its selection committee for choosing me for this outstanding honor. As you know, the Human Growth Foundation helps children who have growth deficiency and their families and their caregivers. Most of these children have growth hormone deficiency, Turner syndrome, achondroplasia, and related disorders. As a result, most of the time that the Human Growth Foundation has recognized the scientist, it's been one who has been working in one of these diseases. My work has been a bit different. My laboratory studies steroidogenesis and its disorders. These disorders affect about one in every 10,000 people, or about 35,000 people in the US. These disorders can show up during fetal life, in the nursery, in the growing child, as problems with puberty, and even can show up in adults. Steroid hormones regulate a variety of processes in our bodies. They determine the sexual development of the fetus. They determine salt and water balance in infancy and childhood. They facilitate childhood growth. They mediate the growth spurt, and they eventually stop our growth. They also regulate salt and water metabolism, blood pressure, immune responses, stress responses, calcium metabolism, and bone growth. In order to do this, we have to make a large number of different kinds of steroid hormones in our bodies. Starting with cholesterol, we make most of our steroids in our adrenals and gonads. Different sequences of steps, different pathways, take you from cholesterol to the final steroid. So therefore, there's much in common in how we make cortisol, testosterone, estrogen, even the biologically active form of vitamin D. Each of these steps requires an enzyme. An enzyme is a protein that helps you get from one steroid to the next. Each enzyme is encoded by a different gene, and each of those genes can be mutated. These mutations cause a wide variety of different human diseases. There are more than two dozen genes that encode steroidogenic enzymes and its associated factors. There are more than two dozen genes that encode steroidogenic enzymes and related factors. Over the past 40 years, my laboratory has cloned many of these genes, identified mutations that cause disease, discovered new genes, identified mutations in those genes that cause diseases, and discovered new diseases. This has permitted more accurate diagnosis and has permitted clinicians to improve their treatments for children who have these disorders. This work has involved over 100 people in my lab. It has involved collaborators from around the world who have sent us clinical samples, and it has involved collaborators in the basic sciences who have helped us with computational chemistry, pharmacology, and biophysics. This has been a lot of fun. There's practically nothing you can do that is more exciting than to look at a new piece of data and realize that you understand something now that no human being has ever known before. It's been an incredible privilege to have a career of scientific discovery, of helping patients, and of teaching the next generation. So again, I want to thank the Human Growth Foundation for this outstanding honor. Thank you.
I'm staring in the mirror, wondering what I could do better, wondering how I could be anyone but me. 'Cause I'm 13 and the other kids are so mean. Why do they not like me? Why do they not like me? I hear them laugh behind my back and it hurts, but what's worse is when they I've got my lipstick in my hands, 'cause I just wanna be like them. I just wanna be beautiful. I can't be invisible no more. I wanna be beautiful. What's so wrong with that? If I were beautiful, how all my love be back? I would be happy.
17, and he is everything I need. I memorize the freckles on his face, dream about the way he says my name. But she's blonde, she's blue-eyed, she has the prettiest smile. He's in love at 17, but it's not with me. I wanna be beautiful. What's wrong with that? If I were beautiful, he might love me back. I would be happy, beautiful. Beautiful. I'm staring at my daughter. It's like staring in the mirror. She looks upon her pretty face, only sees the mistakes. I don't know what to do to stop this abuse. She is so confused. She needs to know the truth. She is beautiful. Will someone tell her that she is beautiful? The world might love her back if she could be. I'm 13 all over again with lipstick in my hand.
Thank you for joining us for the 16th Annual Human Growth Foundation Awards Gala. We hope to see you all again next year.